Hello everyone and welcome back to another Blender Made Easy tutorial. Today I'm going to be showing you how to create pixelated fire or smoke, whichever one you want, in Blender. This is a very simple and easy way to do this, and what we're going to be doing is creating a fire simulation and then going over to the compositor and doing a little bit of compositing with some different nodes and getting a really cool effect. To get started, we need to go ahead and delete the default cube and then press Shift A. We'll add in a mesh and then a circle. This circle is going to be our emitter for our fire, so I'm going to go into edit mode, then press F to fill in a face. From there, we can go up to object, down to quick effects, and then quick smoke. This will automatically add a domain and a material already in place. Go into front view by pressing 1 on your number pad, and then I'm just going to scale up this domain, then press S and Z and scale it along the Z so we get it a little bit taller. Something like that will look pretty good. From there, we can go ahead and select our flow object, which is this circle, go over to the physics tab, and then we can change the flow type from smoke over to fire. If you want pixelated smoke, you can use that. I just found that the fire looks a little bit more interesting. We also need to set the surface to a value of 1, and this will just make sure the fire is closer to the center of our circle, and then I'm going to enable a texture. We're going to be offsetting the fire so it moves around while it's emitting, and this will give it some more randomness. To do this, we need to go over to the texture panel, click new, and set the type over to clouds. From there, we can set the size down to a value of 0.1, just so the texture is a little bit smaller. Then we can open up the colors and set the contrast all the way up to a value of 5. Where the white is, that is where fire will be emitted, and where the black is, there will be no fire. Then go back over to the physics panel and select that texture in the drop-down menu. We're going to be animating this offset value, so on frame 1, I'm going to click that little button on the side to add in a keyframe. Next, jumping all the way to frame 120, I'm going to set this up to a value of 0.6, and then I'm going to click that one more time. So over 120 frames, it's going to offset the texture so it's moving around. Now let's select our domain and go over to the settings over here. I'm going to turn on adaptive domain so it renders a little bit faster. The resolution I will go up to 64, and we don't really need a high resolution because we're going to be making it pixelated. You don't need any detail in your fire, so leave that at a pretty low number, and 64 is pretty good. I'll turn on high resolution and just leave it at a value of 1, and then underneath the smoke flames, I'm going to turn the reaction speed, this is the height of the flames, to a value of 0.6. One more thing that I'll do is I'll select my circle and give the flame rate a value of 1.5, and this will just make sure the flames are a little bit taller. And that's basically all we really need to do. If you want to, you can add in a turbulence force field just to give it some more randomness, which I will do. I'll add a turbulence right in the middle and set the strength of this to 10 and the noise amount to a value of 1. Now that we've done that, we need to save our project so we can actually bake it, because if we open up the cast settings, it's currently grayed out. So make sure you press Ctrl S and save your Blender file. You can set the end frame to a value of 120 and then save your project and then click on bake. The baking is now done. Now if we press play, we can see our animation, and that looks pretty cool, and this will give us a really nice pixelated fire effect. I'm going to set the end frame down here to a value of 120 as well. And now let's open up the material. To do that, split the view and go over to this menu here and click on Shader Editor, then press N to close off. This is our current fire material, and if I press Z and go into rendered view, we will only be able to see smoke. That is because we need to turn up the black body intensity all the way up to 1. Now this looks pretty good, but the fire is not that bright. So what you can do is set the temperature to 1300, and that will brighten it up just a little bit. And you can also manually set the black body intensity higher. So let's go with a value of 3, and as you can see there, it's a lot brighter and it looks pretty good. The density of the smoke, I'm going to turn up to a value of 15 so we get some nice pixelated smoke, and there we go, that looks pretty good. Jumping over to the EV settings, I'm going to open up volumetrics and set the tile size down to 2 pixels, then turn on volumetric shadows. From there, we can go down over to the film section and turn on transparency so we don't get a background. Now let's set up the camera view and render out a single frame. So I'll go into solid view so it stops glitching, then I'll go into front view by pressing 1 on my number pad, and hit Ctrl Alt 0 to snap the camera to place. Select it, press G to move, and just place it how you want. From there, you can select a frame of which you want to render, and I will go with frame 40 because we have some smoke in our scene, and then I will go up to render and click on render image. And this should only take a second, and there we go. And now it doesn't look good at all. Now the reason for that is because we haven't done any compositing. So what we're gonna do now is exit out of this window, go over to the compositing tab. I'll close off this panel, then I'll press N to close off that panel so we have some more room. Then I'll hit Control Shift left click on the render layer to bring in a viewer node so we can see what we're doing. You can press V or Alt V to zoom back in, and I'll go with something like that. The first node that we'll be adding is a scale node. So basically what we need to do is scale down the image and then scale it back up so it has that pixelated effect. I'm gonna press Shift A, go over to distort, and then scale and place that here. Take the image, plug it into the composite, and then over in this size, we're gonna set this to a value of 0.05 on both the X and the Y. So we have a very, very small image. Then if we press Shift A, go over to filter and then pixelate, we can place that here. And this will give us that pixelated effect. Then we need to scale up our image back to its original size. So I'm going to select my scale node, Shift D that and place it over here. I'll take the image and plug it into the composite. And then for the scale, we need to go with a value of 20. And there we go, we have a pixelated fire effect. Now, if you want smaller pixels, you can just turn down the size here, but then you will also need to turn up the size on this scale value. What I said right here is actually incorrect. If you want smaller pixels, you will need to turn up the size on the first scale node and turn down the size on the second one. If you want bigger pixels, then you would have to turn the size down on the first scale node and turn the size up on the second scale node. So for example, let's go with a value of 0.1. And since this is too big, we need to scale this down to 10. And there we go, we have smaller pixels, but as you can see, it doesn't look as good, so I'm gonna go back. The next thing I'll do to add a little bit more interesting effects to this is I'll add in a black outline around where the fire is. This will just give it a more cartoonish, pixely effect. So to do that, it's pretty easy. You need to go Shift A, go over to Filter, and then Dilate or Erode. We'll place that right here. Take your image and plug that into the mask. Then we need to press Shift A, go over to Converter, and then Set Alpha, and we'll place that here. Take the mask and plug that into the alpha. Then we need to combine these two, so I'm gonna press Shift A, go over to Color, and then Alpha over, and place that here. Take the image, plug that into the composite, and then take the image and plug that into the top input of the Alpha over node. And now if we turn up the distance, we can see that we have a small black outline around where the pixels are, and that looks pretty cool. If you want to change the color of the outline, you can just do that here. So if I wanted a blue outline, we can do something like that. I'm just gonna leave it as black. I also noticed that if I turn up this value here, it just looks a little bit better. The fire is a little bit more saturated, and I think that looks pretty cool. If you're not liking how the fire looks, you can add in a color and then color balance node and play around with the highlights. And the highlights is this far right value here. So if I want it to be a little bit more orange, I can drag that over to the bottom left. And that will give us a more orange fire as you can see there. I think it's fine how it is, so I'm just gonna delete that and plug this back in. And then the last thing that we can do is add in another color and then alpha over node, and we'll place that here. Now, what we need to do is take the image, plug that into the bottom input, then this top input here controls the background. So you can leave it as white, you can put it as a green screen, so if you wanted to put this over some footage or something like that, you can put that there, or you can just leave it as black. I'm gonna go with a dark gray color so we can actually see the outline right there, and now let's go ahead and render this out. I'm gonna save my project once again, go over to the output settings, and set this to a folder of where I want to save my file. Once you have your folder, just go ahead and click accept. Now, since we are rendering in Eevee, this is going to go really fast, so I don't see the need to render this out into frames, so I'm just gonna go with a movie file. From there, you can save your project and go up to render and then render animation. Then it will start to render out, and you can see once it goes there, it's rendering into pixels and then it's simulating and it looks pretty cool. The render is now done. Now to view the animation, we can go ahead and exit out of this window, go up to render and click on view animation. This will bring up a new window and we will be able to see our render in real time. So there you go, that is how you create a pixelated fire effect using Blender. Now you can pixelate any render using this exact same method, just use the scale, pixelate scale, and then plug that into the composite, and you'll be able to see any render with this pixelated effect. If you enjoyed this tutorial, make sure you give it a like and comment down below what you would like to see a tutorial on next. If you are new to the channel, go ahead and click that subscribe button so you can stay notified whenever I upload a new Blender tutorial. Thanks again for watching, and I will see you in the next video.